overestimate the change that will happen in the next 2 years and underestimate the change that will occur in the next 10. And I think that's because, as humans, we tend to think about the development of and the impact of technology as a linear thing. And so, as a business leader, understanding where a given platform is on a curve is essential. And I think there's two primary dimensions. The first dimension is around atom complexity. So at one end of the spectrum, things that are larger, more complex, maybe have more invention, are more expensive, and at the other end of the spectrum, less atom complexity, smaller, simpler, and inexpensive things. And the second dimension is whether or not there's a requirement for behavioral change on the part of the user. Something at one end of the spectrum has low behavioral friction, requires less change, and at the other end of the spectrum, something requires much more change. And so we can use this model to think about how technologies in our industry evolve and get adopted by customers. At one end of the spectrum, if you are making something, if you have a piece of hardware that requires lots of change by the user, has many more atoms or is much more complex, that's going to get adopted more slowly. Fewer atoms requires less change, still requires change, that's slow, then fast, and ultimately the fastest technologies to get adopted are those that have the least amount of atom complexity and requires the least human behavioral change. The question that you're asking yourself is like, yeah, but isn't it about the games? Like, what about the content? And yes, it is true, games and the content make a huge impact. And you can apply a force multiplier for breakthrough content. And so you really have to think about the development and adoption and proliferation of these technologies really along three dimensions ultimately. The complexity, the cost on one axis, the degree of behavioral change required by the users on another axis, and then whether or not there are or are not defining pieces of content. At one end of the spectrum, if you combine all those three things, if you have something that is complicated, something requires lots of change, has no killer apps, that's going to get adopted very slowly and will be a very small market. And at the other end of the spectrum, very quickly and be very big. Because there's a point where when reality sort of exceeds expectation, it always looks like you're at the top of the market because you're in uncharted territory. But literally, because we are beyond those expectations, it's hard to know if you truly are at the top of the market. So in short, right, we often think we're here pretty much for every day after we exceed those expectations. But in actuality, we're here. It takes like a new reference point to redefine where the top might be. But even then, we tend to use prior reference points to predict the new peak. So, you know, everyone's trying to guess how big is Pokemon Go right now, how much revenue is it doing, and what we're really using is we're using what we already know to forecast the performance of Pokemon Go. The reality is, number one has no relation to number two, right? It's just more than number two. Is it a dollar more than number two? Is it 500% more than number two? You kind of just don't know. And our job as kind of like game makers is to constantly be trying to find new number ones.